Dear colleagues, dear friends, we have reached the end of the 50th General Assembly, and it is my pleasure to provide some closing remarks. A sad task, as we shall be closing the door to a very productive, stimulating, and lively assembly, and bid farewell to friends and co-workers. I'd like to start by reinstating how honored I am to have this opportunity to lead the European Olympic Committees, and pledge to do my best to further elevate European sport in challenging times. I have listened to you, and I'm confident we'll all join forces to ensure we keep the wheels turning by enriching and establishing European sport high in the global sports chart. We need to fight together to get for sport a fair share from our government's budget for the recovery funds after this pandemic. We share many of the same concerns and see the same challenges, but we also have the right armor to turn these challenges to unique opportunities. Opportunities like reinforcing the European sports model, using digital technology to unlock growth, create an online platform for knowledge exchange. We have much to learn from each other. Focusing on funding and policy to improve financial well-being of our NOCs. Our Brussels office can be a focal point that serves all 50 European Olympic Committees. Align our goals with the EOC Strategic Agenda 2030. Samorin, our seminar, can serve as a fantastic place that your views can be expressed and taken into consideration moving forward. Further develop our shared assets, and most importantly, our competitions that we have. The EOYF is the great platform for our young athletes. We need to further build on their success. We heard here that Vukati and Banka Bystrica are going to be great places for the new meetings of our youth. They all need it because they have been away from competition for some time due to the pandemic. Malta will also be a great place for the games of the small states. And we, as EOC, we need to do as much as possible to help the small states because these competitions are very important for them. Finally, the European Games, our baby product, which is not a baby anymore, has grown. Not only will we have sports in Poland that will be at the highest level, and this is what we're aiming, some sports will be Olympic qualifiers, some sports will be the European Championships of that year, and this way, we ensure that the best athletes will be present. The new broadcasting agreement with EBU will give the possibility to all of the citizens of Europe in a free TV to be able to watch the achievements of our athletes. And this is very important for our athletes, for our NOCs, for sport, but also very important for EOC because that will produce us new commercial opportunities. To this point, I would like to announce that I have asked our past president, Nils Nygaard, to be the vice chairman of our coordination commission for the Polish European Games, and gladly I can say and I can report to you that he has accepted. Nils. Nils, we need you in the family, and I'm sure that you're going to help tremendously for the success of the European Games in Krakow, Malopolska. As we heard earlier on also, we need to leverage our athletes to play an even more important role in our decision making. It's something that we owe to the athletes, and will give them a voice in the executive and a vote as well. We need to find sustainable solutions to ensure lasting success. Green sport, as you heard, will be the name of the game in the future, and we should need to be pioneers in that effort as well. And we will succeed all of these challenges that we said by emphasizing to integrity, transparency, and good governance. We heard many proposals to modernize our statutes and keep going ahead. We shall stay alert for everything that lies ahead, as the only constant in life is change. Convinced that we'll do this as a team, leading together, we rely on you, and thank you very much. Finally, now I wear a different hat as president of the Hellenic Olympic Committee. Would like to thank you all for having been here with us in Athens, in Greece, in the birthplace of the Olympic Games, for this General Assembly, the first major event in person that we've managed to have after the pandemic. We're happy that so many of you were able to be here. We showed our flexibility to bend our rules. So I saw many of us hugging each other, kissing each other, but it was really worth it. We needed it all. And now I would like to wish you safe travels back home. And of course, see you in Tokyo in 40 days from today. Thank you very much, all. Thank you for your confidence.